that whatever we talk about today will be, again, yeah, will be useful for our classroom, for our teaching, and personally for our development as a teacher. Right. So without further ado, I will start my presentation. Right. Yeah. The theme of the presentation is this webinar is using chat based AI assistant. And if you haven't noticed, I believe that you have seen a lot of this in different aspects of our life, technology these days, AI everything, right? I mean, when we always hear AI in sports, for example, there is also AI in technology, of course, AI in education, in the economy, business, and so on. AI this and AI that. At some point, some people have started to think that, at some point, we start to think that probably AI has already taken my job. But I think I would like to think a little differently. Instead of facing AI as our competitor, I really think that AI should be our allies. So instead of saying that AI took your job, I believe that we should make it into AI will take my job to the next level. Okay, so this webinar here, the create formula in using AI assistant, hopefully will lead us to that point, yeah, the next level of teaching, right? So yeah, well, the plan of this presentation is that I will start with talking about AI chatbots for teachers, available AI chatbots for teachers, and then the formula create in using the chatbots, and then probably later on we will talk about designing activities from what we have and using the help of AI. What we can, what kind of activities or what kind of classroom tools that we can have with using AI. Okay, and then try to implement create. There will also be a discussion and workshop at the end of the presentation later. And yeah, last one before the closing, we will have some comments and feedback. Q&A sessions as per usual. Yeah, so I hope that everybody can follow through till the end of this webinar later. Let's start with this. Yeah, I believe that everybody is already familiar with ChatGPT, but at least encountered it once a while. Yeah, well, actually, there are a lot of AI chatbots out there. Some of them are pretty similar, and some other are probably more specified to different purposes. Okay, we have ChatGPT, for example. Similar to ChatGPT, Google, Google actually produced their own AI assistant, AI chatbots called Gemini. This one is from Google. And the one that we're going to be using a lot today, the one that I will try to explore more today is the one from Microsoft, Copilot. There are also other AI chatbot like Hugging Chats, Character AI, and Cloud AI, which works in a similar manner, actually, to ChatGPT and Copilot and Gemini, but with different perks here and there. Okay, so yeah, if we have time, probably we'll talk more about that later. But for this time only, we will focus more on the use of Microsoft Copilot. Why do I choose Copilot actually for this one? Well, Copilot is linked directly to a Microsoft account. And with a Microsoft account, you can access online Microsoft 365 suites. Yeah, I'll show you later. And then this Microsoft suite is comparable to Google Workspace suite. So yes, I believe that all of us now are really familiar or even cannot be separated from what we call Google Drive, Gmail, Google Docs, Google Sheet, Forms, and then so on. Microsoft has all of that actually, similar to that. And then different to ChatGPT. ChatGPT, up to this day, I think that ChatGPT still doesn't have the ability to generate pictures, while Copilot can. So that's a good perk. And then there will also be some plugins integration later. So in Copilot, like plugins, so you can add another plugin to add more feature to the chat assistant. Let's talk about Microsoft Suites first a little bit. Is everybody familiar with these icons? Yeah, I think you can write in a
Yeah, we are. We
yeah.
are.
Yeah, we're familiar with that. Yeah. Okay. How about this too?
Familiar, but rarely use them, I think.
We use, I think. How
OneDrive,
about this?
OneDrive,
How
and
about this?
OneDrive.
How about this other two?
Shit, Microsoft Form.
That's right. And the last one? So the first one is, yeah, with a Microsoft Suite, you can actually access what we call Office Online. So basically, it looks like Microsoft Word, Microsoft PowerPoint, and Excel that you use, that you install on your computer. Okay. Yes. And then the next one, yeah, the basic principle is the same, but actually, you can use that for free, actually. Outlook is Gmail alternatives, actually. And then OneDrive is G Google Drive alternative. For free, Google Drive gives us usually 15 gigabytes of data, but OneDrive only gives us 5 gigabytes. But I think that's quite a lot for a free service. The next one is Microsoft Form alternative, or G sorry, Microsoft Form, Google Form alternative, and the last one is Microsoft Sway, or Google Site alternatives. So I think this is a whole new suite for us, and I think it's really good when we use Copilot and you have the Microsoft accounts. Not only you can use the Copilot, but you can also integrate it with all other Microsoft suites. And these Microsoft Suites are comparable, I can say equivalent to what we have in Google Workspace Suites. So that's why I really suggest that people would use Copilot. Not Copilot. People would create a Microsoft account at least. Yeah. Now the question is how do you access Copilot? If you use Windows 11 or Windows 10, at least with the latest update, you will see this icon, yeah, on your taskbar, on the bottom corner, on the bottom right corner of your taskbar, and then you can click that, and then yes, you can directly chat to Copilot if you are connected to the internet. Yeah, and there you can Copilot, you can start using Copilot there. You will need to create the Microsoft account later when you have to integrate some other apps, but so far you can use Copilot for simple questions. And then you can use Microsoft Edge, the default browsers in most Windows, in Windows operating system. Yeah, if your laptop has Windows, you can see this icon on the top right corner. You can open that, and then you can actually start using Copilot from there. Yeah, and good thing about using Copilot this way is that you can also ask Copilot to probably try to understand the website for you, try to talk about the website for you, or try to summarize the website for you. Yeah, if you use the Copilot this way. Or the ones that I like to use because in some cases we cannot always rely on Windows, right? Like me, I don't use Windows as my operating system, so most of the time I open Copilot here. Yeah, I go to copilot.microsoft.com and then I will be asked to sign in or to create an account. And then you can create an account by clicking sign up live.com. You can use your Gmail account to create a Microsoft account actually. So it's pretty easy, just like what you do when you try to create an account for Canva or Kahoot or quizzes or something like that. You can access Copilot from there. And it will look like this. As you might see on the right side here, you will see some plugins. Yeah, some additional resources that you optional resources that you can install or you can integrate to your Copilot. Okay, I welcome you while I'm presenting. I really welcome you to try getting a Microsoft account or accessing Copilot at least. Now let's go directly to the formula. Create formula itself is coined by there was a website aifire.com. I will disclose that later, but there was an article about this actually, and then I tried to summarize it, and then I tried to understand it and re-explain it to you the way I implement it. So what you will see later is my own implementation of this formula. This formula stands for character, request, example, adjustment, type of output, and extras. So we will cover six of these principles later. And yeah, hopefully you can follow through to the end. Yeah, let's start with the first one, character. Right? So when we talk about character, well, in AI, in using chat-based AI assistants, the first thing that you would need to consider is to decide the role of your AI assistant, the personality of your AI assistant, or even you can ask the AI assistant to replicate real or imaginary characters. If you want your AI assistant to talk like someone else to you, you can. You can, if you want your AI talk like a really old guy, probably, you can. Yeah, or you can ask your AI to be a superhero, like Captain America and so on. This, the function of this will affect the output and the tone of the conversation. At first, if we decide the characters of our AI, it will help us to later on to direct the expected output and also to probably set the tone of the conversation. Yeah, it will be different. If you talk to Doraemon and if you talk to Albert Einstein, of course, it will be the response will be different. Let me give you an example. Using Copilot, I ask Copilot this. I say, from now on, talk in rhymes like Eminem. And the question is simple: how are you? And this is the response. As you might see, the response is adjusted to the way, yeah, at least to trying to replicate Eminem the rapper. Yo, I'm feeling fine, I'm ready to shine. Here to help you anytime. What's on your mind? What do you need? I'm here to assist, just take the lead. Pretty good rhyme too, actually. Right? So this is the first steps, probably, yeah. This is for fun, actually. On a more serious matter, you can go and ask something like this. You can set the character like this. Right? Yeah, of course, because previously I asked him to be Eminem, so I'm going to ask him to stop being Eminem. I don't want Eminem to teach my kids, my students, right? Therefore, I will tell him, you are now an English teacher from Indonesia. You are about to prepare a lesson plan for a class of 10-year-old students. Now, this one, I also mentioned an English teacher from Indonesia to set the background. Because later on the output, even the choice of word of the AI will be adjusted to that. And this will affect the result. Yeah? And this is the response from the Copilot. Got it? Let's create a fun and engaging English lesson plan for 10-year-old students. Here's a sample outline. I didn't even ask for a sample outline yet, but Copilot has already provided me with some ideas. Okay? So basically, that's the first thing about using an AI assistant. Even though this is, I use the example with Copilot, you can also integrate this. You can also implement this if you use ChatGPT or other AI assistants. But basically, the first thing that we need to consider in engaging a conversation with an AI assistant or chatbot is the characters. You can talk about the types of the class, whether your class is for a conversation class, general English class, or academic writing class. Okay. The age of the students, are they children, adults, or teenagers? Their background. Yeah, we talk about occupations, the nationality of the students, so on, because yeah, there are some cultural things that probably you might be different if we talk about English students in Indonesia and English students from Philippines, for example, there might be some adjustments in cultural background. And then the level of competence, you can tell the AI whether your students are still on elementary levels, advanced, or they can also understand the CEFR reference like C1 or B2 and then so on. Okay, this will affect the output actually later. So if you are asked for an exercise for elementary school students, the result will be different when you ask the exercise for higher intermediate level of competence students. So the result will be adjusted that way. Sometimes you can also add the personality of your class. Do you have a silent class or an active class or a serious class and then so on? Yeah, this will affect the way AI design the result for you. Okay, so those are several things that we need to probably integrate when we talk about characters in using AI. For an extension, if you really want to focus on characters, you can go to Character AI, where you can have a chat with a pre-made character made by a lot of other people, as you might see some example there. Yeah, or you can create your own character with a really complete background. There's a story in each different character. And the also good thing about Character AI is that you can actually talk and hear the response, hear the audio response from the AI. So it's not only chat-based, but also you can speak, you can talk about it. Yeah. In that way, Character AI is more focused on building a character as a conversation partner. You can check that out to go and just Google Character AI. Yeah. All right. Now we've done with character. The next thing is, of course, in the prompt, we will ask the AI to do something. So therefore, the next important thing to consider is your request. Most of the time, when you're about to teach or when you're about to use the AI to help you to prepare for teaching materials, there are two situations. First one is when you know what to do, and the second one is when you just don't. I mean, yeah, it happens to all of us, yeah, teachers, right? Sometimes we, okay, I know what to do with my class, and then I'm just going to do this and so on. And sometimes we just went there and sit down and wondering, what am I going to do with my class? Well, both situations can also be, both situations are good, yeah, if you want to say, I have to help you. And you know what to do, you can go on to a more specific and detailed prompt. And sometimes you can just go straight to the point. When you already know what to do, okay, I need this exercise. So therefore, I'm going to ask the AI to create it. And yes, you would have clear scope and limitations. So it's easier, it's faster actually. It's faster for the AI to get what you want. But sometimes, or I don't know, maybe most of the time, yeah, we don't know what to do with our class. We are probably, by the end of the term, we start to run out of ideas. What am I going to do with my class? It's not wrong. It's not a bad thing too. With AI, you can start with a more general ideas and then you add details as you progress. We'll see this in practice right away. Yeah. Let's start with the specific request first. You already know what to do. You already know what you need, and then you ask the AI to create something for you. So this is what I do. Yeah, I will ask Copilot to generate 10 imaginary IDs for a children conversation class. Include name, nationality, dreams, and hobby. And guess what? Here is the result. So yeah, actually in this case, I plan to have like a flashcard for my students. I need to create flashcard for my students so that during the eternal mingle, they can introduce themselves as someone else and talk about their dream, hobbies, and nationality. And I need 10 flashcards for that. So I ask AI to do this. This is a sample of specific requests when you already know what to do. Yeah, I want to do this in my class and I need this and so on. And the AI will help you to provide that. But sometimes, then again, for me, it's most of the times, I just don't know what to do. So therefore, I will tell AI that I don't know what to do, actually. Yeah, I don't know what to do. I'm about to teach English for a class of 10-year-old students. And we're supposed to be talking about dreams for the future, but I have no idea where to start. So tired, please help. You can do a little bit exciting too. You can also use AI as your therapist, actually. So I'm so tired, please help. And guess what? Here is the response. Yes, with probably a warm welcome. It sounds like you have a lot on your plate. Let's make this easier for you. Here are some ideas to get your student excited. Well, actually, the real prompt would be longer than this. There are at least 3 or 4 ideas provided by Copilot. But basically, even if you don't know what to do, you can tell AI that. And then you can start from there with the ideas given by the AI. Okay, I think this could be applied in my class. And then you can go on and ask AI to elaborate more on that. We'll get to that in the example and adjustment later. But basically, even when you don't know what to do with your class, you can use AI to tap that idea to you. So you can start, so things can get going. Yeah, your lesson planning can get going, even when you're saying that you probably have no idea what to do. You run out of ideas. It happens to a lot of teachers, right? So therefore, this, I think, in a way, really helps us teachers. Yeah? Well, several things to consider about characters is that you can... First thing is that asking general questions will help us generate ideas even when we don't have one. Yeah? And then being specific and detailed will save time and help avoid distractions, of course. Usually, when you don't know what to do with your class and then you ask AI to help you, it will take some time to get to the real activities, to get to the, let's say, practical application or whatever the AI is saying. But by being specific, it saves you a lot of time. Yeah, so you already have ideas and give AI, need the AI to help you in a way, you can. Then, actually to help to in being more specific, the next letters in create, this example, is a little more straightforward way. I'm going to go on with that. Yeah. Example is basically, I can say that it's like cheating. Not in good, not in a bad way, but it's like copying something. Yeah. Some AI chatbots has, yeah, most AI chatbot will receive plain text input. You can put, you can request by typing, yeah? You can add the text there, just like what we did so far. Some other AI, yeah, Copilot included, can receive, ChatGPT can also do that now. Can receive pictures and screenshots. Yeah, so they can read the screenshot for you. They can understand what you are screenshooting for them. Some other AIs, yeah, excuse me, from what I've known, I've tried so far, only ChatGPT and Cloud AI will accept other files, like Excel file or like text file and so on. So other than pictures. Yeah, for that, I think ChatGPT and Cloud AI can be used. Yeah, I think for the file input, it will be useful for, teachers, but I think it will be more useful for those who want to analyze data. I don't know if there are Leah's data department here. You can start probably to analyze data. By just giving the AI the Excel file and ask it to analyze for you. Yeah. So these are several inputs that you can use for AI chatbots. Now that we can add pictures, so we normally have this today. Yeah, we have a textbook in the form of PDF or an exercise in the form of PDF. So this is a sample PDF file of our textbook. And what I did was I take screenshot for this part. And what I want to do is actually pretty simple. I want to create more variations for this. Yeah, so basically, I want to create different variations for this conversation to be used in my classmate. So I take screenshot for this. Yeah, you can take a screenshot on your computer, copy, and then I just paste it, just like when you copy paste a picture in your WhatsApp web. It's pretty similar to that. Put the picture there and ask AI to read the conversation in the image and create three other versions of the conversation. Change the places and names, but maintain the structure. So I really want the AI to to duplicate this, but with little adjustment, which are places and names, but the structure should remain the same. And guess what? I got it. I got the all three new conversations based on the picture, which I don't have to type on the chatbot, but I actually got this kind of result. I think it's pretty impressive how technology has gone so far. So it will read the image for you. So you just screenshot it, look at this, duplicate this, change something. And yes, you got something like this. And then in doing this, I also did the same with ChatGPT. And I have to admit, the result is a lot better in this case for ChatGPT. Yeah, compared to Copilot. So basically, Copilot can replicate pictures, so it's possible to have picture as the input and as the output. In that case, Copilot won. However, when it comes to optical character recognition or reading text from a picture, ChatGPT so far provides better results from what I've tried. Yeah, well, because since both are available for free, so I tend to use both actually in most cases. And yeah, there are some extensions too, actually. If you are really in a hurry, sometimes you can take pictures with your phone and use them as the input for your AI assistant. Yeah. However, in doing this, you need to make sure that the text is properly aligned and readable. Sometimes it's hard for the AI assistant to read, an inclining text. If the text goes up or goes down too much, it can confuse them. So make sure that text is properly aligned and readable. And usually, you can use apps like Microsoft Lens. It's like a PDF maker or PDF scanner, or let's say file, document maker, yeah, document scanner for your on your phones. Can take picture with this and it will help you align the picture so that it looks like a proper document. And then you can upload that to a Copilot or a ChatGPT and start ask them to replicate that. Okay. I was talking about Microsoft too much here. It feels like I'm endorsing Microsoft. I don't actually, yeah. So just because that they so far for me, yeah, they have provided a lot of good tools when it comes to documents and teaching aids. Yeah. Right. The next letter in AI is adjustment. Adjustment is actually the ideas of, well, it's pretty simple actually, right? I mean, we need to understand the basic principle of AI chatbots first. We are used, my generation, I think, are used to Google search. So what we did was search Google. What we did was search Google and expected the result that we want. And then we go on by ourselves from there. But this paradigm has changed a little bit when using AI chatbot. I mean, well, back when I was in college, I remember that when I need something, I will ask Google something, and then when I get the result, and then I will move on from that by myself. But AI, it's pretty much, there's a difference there. This kind of AI is called what it's called the NLP or natural language processing, which means you can talk or you can chat as if you are talking to humans. So it's not like talking to a robot or a search engine. You should treat it as if you are talking to human. I'm not asking you to be emotional with the AI. Yeah. Jangan sampai baper juga, right, with the AI. But basically, it's the the conversation can go on. If you are not satisfied with the first result, after you give the AI the prompt, you can ask them to probably revise it or probably totally change that or probably do some adjustment. This is where adjustment is needed. Yeah. AI chatbots also learn from the input you give them. So the more you use them, the more personalized they get. Yeah. I think all my AI chatbot, like my ChatGPT or my Copilot accounts, I already understand that I am an English teacher from Indonesia. So when I ask them something, there is a little bit of that is put into the output of the AI. And this is also why I really suggest that everybody create an account for their AI assistants. Why? Because you want the result to be more personalized to your use. So it's easier. So the more you use it later, the more accurate probably, or the more the result would be much more like what you expected. Yeah. And yes, AI chatbots are conversational and contextual. So most of the time, I rarely got into one prompt and the result directly is there. I rarely got into that. But most of the time, what I do is to get to the expected result, it will take several prompts. Yeah, I will chat a lot, like I talk to someone who knows better. Now think of AI assistant as your super, super intelligent friend. Can answer everything you ask him. Yeah, so it takes several prompts to get the result. Even say, for example, you're not satisfied with the first output from the AI, you can go on and ask the AI to revise it, to probably change it, and to totally change it, and some other things. And then, yeah, it is written actually in all AI services, AI chatbots, they make mistakes. So in some cases, you would need to review and adjust. Yeah. Just for example, last night, I asked AI to talk about someone, some names from the book. And then because I don't know that person, and then it seems like the AI also don't know that person. So they just give me some random information about that person. When I check back, oh, it's wrong actually. So it happens sometimes that AI can make mistakes, but in most cases, yeah, this is where we play a role. Yeah, we can review and adjust the result of that AI. Yeah, this is a sample prompt for adjustment. Remember, previously I asked the AI to give me some ideas on what to do to my class. So this one, the AI start with a story. And then the adjustment that you can do is, remember the AI is contextual, so you can refer back to the previous output. The continuation of that conversation is this. I'll pick number one, the story. The grammar focus is using simple past tense. Can you elaborate? And then you can go on with that. Even examples and so on. This is what I mean by adjustment. Let's go back a little bit. So in this prompt, the AI provides me with some ideas. And then I have chosen the first idea, but I need a little more adjustment, which is focusing on the simple past tense. And then the AI would give me another output as, with the adjustment that I gave them. So in this case, yeah, in this case, this is really a really good thing to change our paradigm about how to use AI. Yeah. So after the first output, you can always refer back to the first output. Look at number three. I want you to elaborate this and change this into something, something, and so on. So you can go on with that. Yeah. So basically, in the adjustment part, it's like the understanding that we can, before we get to our expected result, you can always ask AI and even force them to move to the direction that you want. So, yeah. That part is the adjustment. And a little bit related to the adjustment is the types of output. The fifth level of create is T, or we call it the types of the output. Previously, we talked about input, yeah, plain text and pictures and some other AI copilot. Some other AI like files and so on. In Copilot, you can have text and image as the output. This also applies to ChatGPT and what do we call it? This also applies to ChatGPT, Cloud AI, and Gemini. You can provide text and some other image. Yeah, from the text, you can also ask the Copilot to switch into table. We'll talk more about why we need table later. Some other AI tools like PlayHT or Character AI can actually provide you with audio. Yeah. Well, so far for now, Copilot and ChatGPT haven't utilized the audio as the output yet. But I think in the near future it will happen. I believe that it will happen. So one AI for all. Yeah. The good thing about Copilot is that it can generate image. Now, for English for children teachers, for example, yeah, for children classroom, we need a lot of. Sometimes we need a lot of pictures to teach vocabulary quickly. For example, you would start to need a lot of pictures, and yes, Copilot can help you to do that. Of course, there is a limit actually if you want to generate pictures, but basically the limit resets. Daily. So yeah, you can have some pictures today and then some other pictures tomorrow. Today. Yeah, this is an example of what I did with Copilot. Generate pictures of a cute dinosaur playing soccer in the jungle on a bright sunny day. The dinosaur's face is serious and make it dramatic. It will take some time to get the result. It will load, and it depends on your internet connection too, but basically, this is the result. I think it's pretty accurate to what I am depicting in the to what I was depicting in my prompt. A dinosaur, playing soccer in a bright sunny day, and then it's serious and it's on. Yeah. And if you need, usually, yeah, you might see here, there is a token here. This token means that several the prompts, the how many prompts are left for you to generate pictures. So 12, if it's reached zero, it will reach zero, so you cannot generate pictures anymore for that day. But it usually will reset on the next day. Yeah, the first token is, I think, about 20 tokens and so on. Because it's a free service. If you want more, you probably would need to subscribe to Microsoft 365. Yeah, basically, for our need, you can do this. And also, during our discussion last week, I also remember that Tebe reminds me that, oh, you can also create multiple pictures. So to save your tokens, you can ask it to create multiple picture multiple things in one picture, like generate a picture of classroom objects, include pen, paper, pencils, book, and pencil case, and so on and so on. So it will give you a lot of pictures in a lot of things in one picture. It will help us in providing teaching aids. Well, if you want to focus more on image generating pictures, some other AI tools are more specialized in that. Canva has a built-in AI image generation today. There's also tools like FreePic, DALL-E, Pixar, Deep AI, and then yeah, I think this one is the mother of all the stuff. Some of us probably have heard about Stable Diffusion. Yeah, the technology behind this is also Stable Diffusion. You can check that out. Stability AI. So if you really want to focus more on picture generations, you can go on and check these other services out. Yeah, the next one, like I told you earlier, we can create table as the type of output. Now, as someone who deals a lot with, as a teacher who deals a lot with preparing teaching aids, and I tend to use one of my main tools in preparing a teaching aid is, of course, Google Sheet or Microsoft Excel. Yeah. In creating tables, it helps me to create some printable materials. And then even, we'll talk more about this later, there are some certain templates from other platforms like Kahoot and Quizzes in the form of table. So basically, it can it can help you create a Quizzes set or a Kahoot set a lot easier if you put them into table. For example, this is what I did a few weeks ago. What I had here is a TypeScript, a conversation transcript example. And this one is taken from part one of a TOEFL practice test. As you might see, if you notice there, yeah, there are speaker one, speaker two, the narrator, and the question. I want to do some adjustment to this because there are certain activities that I made. So I asked ChatGPT to do this. Separate this chat transcript into three columns in a table. The headings are letter, speaker one, and speaker two. Each line under the respective heading should be the content of the row. Then here are the transcript. And yes, you might guess the result. It gives me something like this. A really good table. So yeah, normally before chatbots are there, doing something like this would take your copy-pasting skills. Yeah, copy, paste, and so on. But now you can simply give the data to ChatGPT. To Copilot or ChatGPT. ChatGPT can do this too. Kill it. And then ask them what to do. And yes, you get a better with this. Yeah, you can go on and move on to what you're planning to do. We'll talk more about this later in the in extras part. But basically, you can help. You can use AI assistants or chatbots to give you a table for better, maybe printable materials, or maybe for something else. We'll see. We move on from this on later. But for now, one thing that I like to use Copilot or ChatGPT on is that student grouping with gender guessing. Yeah, so I have, say, for example, 16 students in my class, and I want to create four groups. And then, but I want the students to be, to be balanced. There are women and there are girls, and because my classroom is still a teenager class, for example, and I want them to be balanced between in a group, there should be a male students and there should be female students. So this is what I asked Copilot to do. put the students into four groups equally, and then make sure there are male students and female students in the group. Guess the gender by looking at their names, and then the students are Indonesian. Remember, the background is needed, actually, so that they know that these are Indonesian names. Yeah? And then I also ask, after that, I also ask them to put it into a table so that it's easier for me to show my students. So this is what I got. Group of students with gender guessing. So I'm trying to make sure that in each group there are male and female students. Yeah. How do they decide the gender? Yeah, based on the common names that they know and the data. For this one, I tried both in ChatGPT and Copilot, and both provide a similar result. But I think Copilot is better in that name guessing, gender guessing than it. And you got the table, yeah? So that's about the output, actually, of the types of output of ChatGPT, of Copilot and other AI systems. By knowing the type of output that we want, it will help us better later to create what kind of activities do you want to design. Yeah, that part will be covered in extras. In this part, we will talk about probably utilizing other services or other tools to help us to get what to provide a better teaching aids. Yeah. First thing first that we need to realize, there is no super apps. Yeah. This presentation, most of the time in this presentation, I talk about Copilot, but it doesn't mean that I endorse Copilot so much. No, Copilot is not perfect too, the same way with ChatGPT and other tools actually. So I believe for teaching, there is no super app. Therefore, combination and integration of other apps or services are needed if you really want to prepare for your classroom. And then, luckily for us teachers, most apps and services that can help us in teaching are available for free. Some of them, of course, with limited features, but I think if you are tricky enough, if you can think a little bit out of the box, you can utilize different services to get what you need. I'll show you an example. I'm just going to show this later, yeah? Some of us are probably familiar with the Kahoot and Quizzes sheet template. So I'm just going to show you, yeah? This is... This is a Kahoot template in the form of Google Sheet. You can simply download it from Kahoot website. Yeah. So basically, this sheet can be filled with questions. This is the question, and these are the answer. 1, 2, 3, 4. A, B, C, D for Kahoot. Hope it's big enough. Right? And as you might see here, this is in the form of table. So what I did was, I want to prepare a Kahoot, but I don't have time to create the question by myself. That's the condition there. So what I did was, I opened Copilot. I asked, Copilot to, as you might see here, create an exercise for a simple past tense for elementary school students. Level of competence is elementary to intermediate. Make 10 questions focusing on the use of verbs and the types of exercise is multiple choice, and use 1, 2, 3 as the options. Nice. As you might see here, okay, Copilot gave me the result. But if you think about it again, I have to put it here. And I don't want to copy paste it one by one. It takes too much time. It takes too much time to do that. So therefore, yeah, let your AI assistant do that. So the next thing that I asked Copilot to do is create a table for that exercise you just made. The first column should be for the questions. The next column are the options. Sorry for the typo and mistyping. And then this is the table that it gives me. Question 1, 2, 3, 4. The options are over here. The table is ready. Almost ready, actually. So we have the question. Option 1, 2, 3, and 4. But in this case, Kahoot also asked us to provide the time for the question, and then the time to do the question, and then the number for the correct answer. Okay, you can do this manually. You can, from this on, you can copy paste this or open in Excel. You can copy paste this here, and then you can do this manually. But I was too lazy to do that. So I asked, great, add two more columns to the right. Six columns should contain the number 30 for the time. And then the last column should be the number of the correct answer to the question. And here we go. Right, and this is ready for this template. So I'm gonna put this into this template. All right, and then the next thing I would do is to open Kahoot. Just need to show you here. Open Kahoot. Sorry. Create a new exercise and import that. Yeah, and import that. And for more information how importing on Kahoot, I think you can figure it out from Kahoot itself. Basically, I already made Kahoot here, even without preparing, even without typing anything, I'm just copy pasting the questions and the answer and the right answer here. The same goes for quizzes template. Might look a little different, but the principle is the same. Yeah, so you can create a Kahoot or quizzes exercise, even without typing anything. Well, you just need to check the answers or the input provided by Copilot. Yeah, well, actually these days quizzes and Kahoot actually provide some AI assistance in their platform, but by the end of the time it will lead you to buy their premium products. Yeah, so if you are up to it, it's easier to use actually. If you want to use Kahoot and generate question with AI, Kahoot AI, you can actually. Okay. But you can, it will give you some free tire, some free stuff at the beginning. And then if you want more, you would need to subscribe and so on. Well, if that's your choice, that's also okay. Yeah. So this is the first extras to actually utilize other platforms to help you in preparing. Right now, this is another extras that I would like to show you, which is the thing that I did for our sharing sessions a few weeks ago. Yeah, this is a sample classroom activity: listen and match conversation. So I'm going to explain how the activity looks first. Yeah. So this is the worksheet that I made, and what I want was, I want the part. This is for a tuple preparation class or similar. to that? Right. The first one is I want the participants to listen to the first speakers only and take notes on the sheet provided. Right. So what I want to do was this. Yeah, I want the participant to listen to the speaker one and speaker two separately, not in a conversation. And then participants will listen to the second speaker responses and take notes here. And then the participants will match the lines of the first and the second speaker. So after they completed the listening of the first speaker, and then the listening of the second speaker, they need to match which is the proper response. And then with all the information provided, yeah, after checking, I want the participants to guess the question and the answer based on the context of the conversation. Okay, so in order to do that, it might need a little, yeah, I have some ideas what to do. First, I can use audio editor to cut the audio into several parts and combine them again, and then redo that, reproduce that. Another are different types of audio to do that, or I can just, yeah, because what I had was only this, I only have the original audio back then, so therefore it's pretty hard for me to, yeah, if I have to edit the audio one by one, per conversation, it will take a lot of time. Therefore, this is the workflow for that. First thing first, I went to Author AI. The function of Author AI is to this tool specialize in recording and summarizing meetings, actually, but it can also be used to transcribe audio and then turn that into text. So because I only have the audio file, I didn't even have the transcript. So I will ask Author AI to transcribe the audio for me. And then after transcribing the audio, I would go to Copilot. The one that you just saw about me creating a table for that script is this. I separate the script into first the narrator's line, second speaker's line, third line question, and then put it into the table. Of course, I move on to Google Sheet to prepare the printed worksheet. And last one is to reproduce that audio. In this case, I use Play HD. So I actually really regenerate the audio and then separate. Yeah, the first audio is only, the first audio file is only for first speaker line. The second audio file is for the second speaker lines only. And while at it, because there is a feature in Play HD, I also utilize different accents, so that it can be more challenging for the students, for the participants back. This is how it goes, actually. So I started with only the audio files for the worksheet, and then I managed to create a kind of activities that I think is a little more engaging, especially for TOEFL classes. Now this, especially in listening TOEFL classes, yeah, it's hard. There's not much room to move, yeah, when you teach listening for TOEFL classes. But somehow, with the help of these tools, I think it really helps me in many ways to get to what I want. Yeah. So I believe that, again, there is no super app, yeah, an app that will help you to solve all of your teaching needs. Even there is no such thing as super apps, I would like to say that it shouldn't stop us from being a super teacher. Yeah, there are a lot of free apps out there that can really help us if we utilize them enough. Yeah, and then there are a lot of free services out there so that you can use. I mean, you don't even need to subscribe for premium ones, I think. You can still become a really good teacher who are integrated, yeah, who use technology as your tools in teaching. Right? So to sum up, yeah, the CREATE formula, yeah, stands for character, request, example, adjustment, types of output, and then extra thrust. Yeah. Even though I'm saying this formula as a whole, but actually sometimes you just don't you don't always need to utilize all of them in your teaching preparation. Sometimes you just need to understand some of them, but basically to create an effective form, to create a really expected result, you should try to utilize all the six letters in create in your lesson planning preparation. Yeah, like characters, for example, I think after using ChatGPT or Copilot for several times, it will understand that you are an English teacher, you are preparing something for your classroom, it will try to understand that. So you can skip that part, go directly to the request. Or even if you don't need, say, for example, you don't need other platforms to do that, you can stop in the types of output. But I think the most of the time, adjustment will always need it, because that's the basic principle of natural language processing. It should be back and forth. Yeah, it should be conversational and contextual. Therefore, with this, I really hope that all teachers now can utilize AI not as their competitors, yeah, but more like your allies in teaching. Okay. So I think it should be time for us to go on for a discussion and workshop. So it should be the time for the participants to try out the AI tools that you want to use. Maybe try Copilot in that case. So this is what we are going to do today. Right after this, Mr. Daman will put you into breakout rooms, and in that breakout room, yeah, you will try to do this. Yeah, I'm going to give you this in the chat, and what you need to do is to ask your chatbots to create a sample conversation using these boxes as an input. Okay, and then you should direct the AI to follow the theme or the tone of conversation. So you might see this might be about business. And then include any target grammar and vocabularies. Let's say there are some list of words that you want to integrate in your exercise, in your sample conversation, okay? Or you want the focus of the grammar to be simple present tense or simple, let's say, future tense, talking about the future, okay? So it's up to you, yeah? You can change the, include any target grammars and the vocabulary for this. And then, yes, adapt to the target audience. Yeah, in this case, the material is for conversation students. So probably college students and office workers. And then after the conversation, the model conversation is finished, I also want you to ask the AI to add more exercises and activities based on the conversation that they just did. And of course, try to be as creative as possible. Yeah, so for this, which way, I'm going to share to you the picture. For the task, and Pak Daman later will have to put you into the breakout room, yeah.
Pak, would you share again, Punten, you share again the screen on the sound processor and then transcription?
Sorry, the screen for?
The previous one, the text to sound, sound to, I'm going to photo.
This one? Yeah.
Thank you.
All right. Okay, so yeah, for the discussion and workshop, I think we still have around 15 minutes or so to do this. So what you need to do is this part. I have shared it, please download it in your chat, Zoom chat.
Yeah.
Then Padaman will take you into the breakout room, and then you will, yeah, I hope you can come up with a good result later. Just screenshot when you're finished later, just screenshot your result, the AI prompt result exercise, and then you can share it into Zoom chat again. Yeah, just like what I did here, I screenshot this part and then I put it here. Okay. All right, let's stop there for a while, Padamu.
Okay,
Yeah.
so everyone make sure that you have downloaded the photo in the chat yang Pak Didi has shared before you output in breakout room. Okay, can I start? So there will be 11 group. Oh, sorry, 10. 9 or 10, let's see. 9 group, Pak.
Okay, participants may join the breakout room, ya.
Pak Daman, I'm sorry. I am returned to the main session. Could you please?
Wait. Wait, Debo. Cinta, ya.
Everyone in the breakout room. All right, thank you. I think we can start the demo, yeah. So basically, for our YouTube viewers, this is what the people in the breakout room will do. I just ask them to do this. I ask them to turn this, and this is only what we call sample, only the ID cards, but I want this to be a conversation. So in order to do this, we're gonna need to screenshot this part and then send it to Copilot, and
okay.
Then later on we will move on from that. Yeah, great. So yeah, let's try to do that. First of all, I just want to make sure that the picture is good enough for the AI to read. So I think I'm gonna need a bigger picture. Or if you want to be quick and you don't mind typing, you can just retype this into Copilot. If the picture result does not satisfy you, you can just retype this in Copilot. And next, a screenshot. This part, I don't know if it's seen in Zoom, but basically I just take a screenshot and go to Copilot. Start a new topic. And then We'll ask them read the idea from this card and then generate a conversation between the two people. Generate a conversation between the two people. The topic should be about business and work. Topic should be about business and work. And then, yeah, because the character still hasn't doesn't have name yet, so you can add character, yeah, give names to the characters. And then I haven't provided a picture. Here's it, the ID from this picture. The right decision between two people. Let's try it. Seems like a pilot misunderstood me in this case, and it creates a picture for me. So I think, right, it gives me this picture. Instead, let's do some adjustment with the prompt. Yeah, take the ID from this picture. So let's go on with, maybe we make the picture a little better. Yeah. Okay. We have to re-explain what the picture is for to Copilot. So therefore, I'm going to take another screenshot. This again for character recognition. I think ChatGPT is a lot better. This is a picture. Containing two ID cards. Read the information from read information on the detail and generate a conversation. Right conversation with two people from the release card. See? Yeah, it still understood me as picture. I don't want picture. You can't tell them. Yeah. I don't want pictures. I don't want conversation. There you go. That's it, actually. Got it? Between Alex from Team Hops and Jordan from Bandika. Finally, I got there. It keeps telling me to have pictures. But let's just take that as a bonus in this case, yeah? The picture is for the bonus. Basically, I got the conversation now. And I want to... we need some adjustment here. Thank you, Alex. Your focus is really interesting. Okay. Revise the conversation. request the conversation. Right, the language easier to understand. The students are off in the elementary level, and utilize the use of future tenses. Conversation. Future tense conversation include words like miss business planning. Include words like business planning, sales meeting, deadline, and achievement. So in this case, I got the conversation from the picture. Pretty hard to do. In this case, yeah, Copilot, as I told you earlier, in this case, ChatGPT is provides better result in optical character recognition. But with some adjustment, I don't want pictures. I want a text of conversation. Then Copilot understood me. Oh, this is what you want. This is Alex from Tillops, and then Jordan from Bandika. Hi, Alex. The person really conversation is there. And I just another, I just, and I think after reading it at a glance, this is too much for elementary students, yeah? So therefore, I want the conversation to be a little easier. This is the adjustment. Hey, Jordan, Monica, we achieve great things in science with you. What will you do to keep growing? Thanks, I like you, focus, and blah, blah, blah. Can you help brand conversation? What is your business planning? Okay. Maybe we accomplish what together. I would like to set a meeting to talk about it, and it will be great achievement for us. I think this is really really good. Yeah. Now from this on, you can move on to create a different exercise. Like probably you want this to be you want to probably turn this into something like this one, for example. I have several other tools. This is the extra part, actually. Like I can use this. Yeah, basically this part over here is just a drilling practice, disappearing text. And then I can start with this. Yeah, I can put Jordan's part here and Alex's part on the right side, and then this is actually a disappearing text practice. So basically it will look like this. So when you play it, it looks like this. I can copy paste the text to this slides. And then ask the students, this is a really controlled drilling practice, and ask the student to repeat. And then I will make the text disappear in each slide later. So some text will disappear in each slide, and then by the end of the slide, by the end of the last slides later, the students will start to come up with their own ideas to speak. Hopefully, in this case. Yeah. But basically, from this, what I'm trying to show you here is from this input, we can actually ask The input is pretty simple to ID cars, actually, right? From this input, we can actually ask ChatGPT or Copilot to go on and provide us with a sample conversation. And that sample conversation can be, probably can touch some ideas for us to do, to understand, okay, I want to do this in my classroom. Probably to spark some ideas for you on what to do with this sample conversation. So next one, probably I'll ask them to separate the conversation. Yeah, separate the conversation into tables. Yeah, let's do that. No, this is easier to read, I think, yeah. Next, you're done, next, you're done, and then so on, and then you can move on from this. You can create a review. Okay, the conversation has reached its limit. Sometimes, yeah, when you ask them to generate pictures, Copilot will ask, will limit your conversation, but this is not something that we need to be worried about, because you can always start a new topic with this. I'll copy this one and I ask them to do the same again. You use Copilot and ask, and you ask for pictures. It will sometimes limit your conversation. So see, it's 1 of 5, but actually if it's still needed, it will extend to 30 actually. This is just to remind us that we should be effective in giving prompt, right? Now, if that's the case, we got the conversation from the picture. I want to add more exercise. So for the student, I can ask, wait. I want the AI to actually generate 5 comprehension questions based on the based on the conversation. Okay. All right, I got the questions. Yeah. Maybe need some adjustment. I want multiple choice questions, so therefore. Choice.
Sorry, Mr. Didi, you have 2 minutes before the breakout rooms finish.
No. So basically, what we did there is providing the AI with an input and then redirecting the AI to actually use this use the input and create something for us. And then from you, when you have a conversation, you have something to talk about, you can go on and create and extend more to that. Okay, of course there's some errors there, some adjustment is needed, but basically even with so little input, as remember, I just had this for my class. Even with that little input, you can actually come up with something. Well, I think this is pretty complete. Yeah, you have a conversation, you have some comprehension questions, and then you can utilize that in your classroom with more tools like the use of Google Slides and other tools. Actually, you can have that. So this is how we can use AI with really minimum resources, and then you can go on and you can go on and come up with something that is ready to use in your classroom. Okay.
Okay, thank you.
So let's wait for the people from the breakout rooms, yeah, to come back. Are they coming back or not?
They will come back in 1 or 2 minutes.
So yeah, the AI, yeah. Again, I'm not saying that again, I'm not endorsing Copilot or anything. Yeah, it's a good tool, but I believe that you can always use a different. If one thing doesn't, if Copilot doesn't satisfy your need, for example, you can always switch back to ChatGPT because in many ways it's also good to use, actually. And I also believe that both are available for free. So I don't want you to compete them. Oh, ChatGPT is better or Copilot is better, and so I don't want them. I don't want you to put them into a competition, but more like I want you to utilize both of them. Both of them are available for free, so why not?
Okay, it will be closed in 5, 4, 3. Close the door. Okay, welcome back, participants. Welcome back, participants, to the main room of our Zoom. Oh yeah, I would like to welcome Mr. Hendro Priyatmoko, the Deputy Head of Academic Affairs and Sales of Lembaga Bahasa Lia. Mr. Hendro, welcome to this Zoom.
Thank you, Mbak Seri.
Yeah. So, what did you have from your breakout rooms earlier, sir? Can you share with us?
Okay.
Okay.
Share-nya. First one is this one. So, first is Copilot could read the image. I think that I cannot do that with the ChatGPT, yeah.
So, you can actually.
Bisa? Oh, bisa, Pak.
Yeah, ChatGPT.
Oh.
Can
even, okay. Never tried.
No,
okay, I will try later. And then this is the result. I'm not sure whether the my what you call that my prompt is accurate, gitu ya. At least kayak gini lah ya.
Yeah.
And then this is the result. And then also we created another prompt to create the activity. So it's an activity.
Yes.
They, Copilot, they or he or she?
It. Okay. I don't know. I just asked Copilot, Pak. Yeah. Kau juga
nama
ya.
Saya pakai they aja lah ya. They gitu ya. Okay.
I cannot assume its gender.
Oh, it. Okay, so it produces several activities, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In fact, that we did not provide types of activities that we expected. So it's just like terserah yang maha kuasa gitu ya dari Copilotnya, and then the result would be like this. And then there was a mistake that we did is that we could not we didn't put like the level
of the students. Yeah,
yeah, for the students, like I think using CEFR kayaknya lebih it's better ya, yeah, for Copilot,
yeah,
because it's more common, yeah,
more common.
So that's why if we see the what you call it, the dialogues is just like this. I'm not sure whether it suit the student that we have or not. I'm not sure. Later on, I believe that we have to write down CFR to make it more suitable for the level of the students. Gitu sih. Thank you, Pak Kiki, for sharing this.
Thank you. It's really good. Eh? It's even better from what I did earlier. What,
good idea.
What we did in the demo, Copilot misunderstood me. I want a picture, so I have to re-explain to Copilot that I don't want pictures. Probably some of you experience this too, yeah. Because of that feature, because Copilot can generate picture, sometimes the problem is that when you input a picture, it will expect that, oh, it will think that, oh, you want another picture based on this. No, I just want something else. I want the text. And what Hendro did earlier with the Copilot, the chat-based assistant, I think it's really, really good. Yeah, it provide better result, actually. The AI understands what to do. And then the activities are, some activities are really, I mean, if you are out of ideas, of if you're stuck with what to do with your class, that is, and imagine that Just imagine that that is as little as you providing the input just only from one picture, and then it can expand to a lot of things to do. So I think the age of teachers running out of ideas is coming to an end. Okay, ibu semua ya. I mean ya.
Nice.
Yeah, so
Okay.
the era where okay, I mean yeah, I think that's one of my first struggles in teaching in LIA. I remember my early days in LIA. It's always there. What the hell am I going to do with this class? And then and then.
Confused.
But I think with the help of Copilot, that is a really good one. Yeah. So the
Okay.
group, the Pak Hendro's group earlier, yeah.
Yeah, breakout room too, ya. Yeah?
Breakout room
Big.
two later.
Okay, is we can have one more group if you want to share. Anybody
Anybody?
wants to share your group findings? We can have one more group if you want to share.
And then we will start to discuss the questions.
You can say something. Mm-hmm.
Hello,
or,
I'm in
check, check.
Room. I don't know. Five.
It's okay. It's just a comment about what the activity that we did is also fine.
Four of us in the group, there are four of us. Four
group,
of us.
Group five, Bu Nana.
Yeah.
You are group five.
Five, Pak Daman,
group
sorry.
Five, Miss Nana. Okay.
The problem is we don't know, Pak, which group we belong to.
Yeah, that's
okay.
Why I know. So you are group five.
Group five, please share.
Yeah, Miss Hasri is having things to do. Then I'm in the middle of proctoring the teachers of Surakarta having EPT. Then that's why I asked Pak Daman to share the pictures in the group. But before Pak TB shared the pictures, the image in AO's group, Bu Jini already shared the image in our chat box. And then I opened the chat box and then I screenshot in using my handphone. And then I share to my WhatsApp web and my laptop. And then I use that to copy the image to my laptop, opening the Copilot. And it's very friendly, so it's easy to do that, even if I didn't get the image from Pak TB yet. So it's very easy to do that, to copy the image. And then I share the result in our chat. Can I just share it in the chat here, Bu?
Okay.
Yeah. That, yeah. Here
it is. There is also Copilot result from room 3 in the chat.
Yeah. Okay, wait. The first one is here. Well, I could see in the chat box. I guess when I share in the chat box, it can't accommodate the whole copy. So I shared in two different chats.
Wow.
So that's the result of our discussion. I shared in our chat box.
Okay, that's
pretty easy to do this. Thank you, Pak. That's our sharing.
Thank you very much, Bu Nana. Yeah, thank you very much for sharing. Yeah, it's really good result, actually, right? I also got one from, I don't know, breakout room 3. Yeah, and they got two types of conversations, actually. So I'll go back here. Yeah. Okay.
What's missing is the situation, but to spice up the misalnya in the middle of seminar break atau ketemu di mana.
Yeah, I see that. Yeah, formal tone and casual tone, and you add the situations. That's the adjustment part, actually. And then so yeah, that's pretty good, actually, for all of us. This is really nice, I think. Yeah, even better from what we did in the showcase room. Yeah, actually. Well, basically, that's the whole ideas of using this chat-based AI assistant. We're not, again, it's conversational and contextual. So when you get the first result, and you think that, oh, this is, I don't think this is suitable for my classroom, or I don't think this is too much from the level of competence of my students, you can always revise that. Yeah, I will show you what we did earlier with the same case and what happens earlier. Yeah, some errors too, actually, from what we have here. So this is the same thing that that we did this way.
Okay, we only have some minutes, Mr. Didi.
Yeah, this to
and
show.
Then after this, we have the Q&A. We still have Q&A later.
Yeah. Thank you, Ms. Eric. So basically, what we did, what I did is I gave the picture. Picture is not available anymore. And then it actually gives me pictures back. And then I have to sell this. I don't want to want pictures. I want a text of the conversation. Oh, got it. And so on, so on, and so on. And then we can move on with that. Revise the conversation, make the language easier to understand, and then your students and blah 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 blah. So again, since it's conversational, so it's all right. If the first problem you got a mistake, you don't, it's not like the way you expect it, you can always readjust later. Or at least, especially when you are stuck of ideas, it will spark some ideas in our brain. To get, we can move on from that. Okay, so thank you very much for everyone who did the exercise in the breakout room. That was a really good exercise.
Yes, thank you for sharing.
Yeah, and I hope you love you would love to do that too on your next, on whatever next project you would do. Yeah, Michelle.
Yeah, don't leave yet. We are going to have Q&A session, but before that, we are going to take photo session first, photo session before the question and answer session. So please, everyone, turn on your camera and show us your best smile. Miss Gita will take the picture, yeah? Miss Gita, you are still mute, okay.
Yeah, okay, sorry. Yeah, sure.
I'm going to turn off the chat for when...
Okay, thank you. Wait, I'm still... arranging
oh,
the
Miss Ira,
photo.
You are so sweet. Oh,
okay,
my
there
God.
Are 3 pages. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, smile. Once again. Bear with me. Okay. One last shot. Thank you.
Nice, nice.
Okay. Thank you for your nicest smile, guys. So for the next session is the Q&A session. We have some questions from the Zoom chats and also from the YouTube. I'm going to read the, which one, sir? The YouTube first, maybe? Oh, wait, the Zoom first, yeah? The Zoom first. So it's from Miss Fitri. Miss Fitri is asking, for other AI assistant, free account only accept screenshot once a day. How about for Copilot? Mr. Didi, you are still mute. Sorry. Mr.
Okay.
Okay.
So I haven't tested the limit yet for either Copilot or ChatGPT, actually. But for Copilot, what I've tried is that even if you are stuck with one problem, I mean, the limit for one conversation is over, you can always start a new conversation and talk about it. So in Copilot, there is always that button, yeah, new topic or new conversation. So you can start again and paste that again. I can paste the picture again, you can paste the screenshot. For the limit itself, I haven't really tried it yet. But yes, I tried with ChatGPT. I put some files, actually. I asked ChatGPT to read some files for me. And then I had to wait So after a while, I had to wait for about 1 hour because I just submitted a file, and then I had to wait for 1 hour before I can continue a conversation. So the prompt for that day is limited. Of course, that is the what do we call it? The downside of free accounts. But again, there are a lot of options out there. I really suggest that you also check out. So this is what I always do, yeah. If my Copilot is out of limit, I move to ChatGPT again. And if my ChatGPT is out of limit, I will go back to Copilot. Or sometimes I open Cloud AI and then so on. So the good thing about a lot of free services out there, you can always switch and change. I think that's the answer, please. We share it.
Okay, thank you for the answer, Mr. TD. I hope that answers Ms. Fitri's question. Ms. Fitri, what do you think?
Thank you, Mrs.
Okay. Okay, thank you, Ms. Fitri. So I need to tell you one more question from the platform YouTube, from the one of the YouTube viewers. So Mr. Doni Suseno from El Belia Ciledug was asking, if I input my lesson plan doc to Copilot for some extra ideas, will Copilot claim my original document as its own property? That means I'll lose my authentic doc as that become AI prop.
Okay. This is a really technical question. I'm not sure I can provide the answer accurately. But first of all, so far, Copilot still cannot digest or still cannot read documents. Yeah, even if you try to upload it, it only so yeah to well until to this day, I think it's only pictures or screenshots so far. So document is still not available yet. Other AI tools like ChatGPT or Cloud AI can actually read documents like PDF or docs or Excel file or simple plain text file. They can read that. Now, and you want to ask some, the question is that you want to add some external ideas with Copilot claim. I don't know what does it mean. I'm not really sure about what claiming means here, but of course your file will be digested, will be read by that AI assistant, and then the AI assistant will spit out what you want them to do. If you want them to summarize files, summarize things, it will happen. So I don't know about the authenticity and the I'm not really sure about the authenticity of the documents and then so on, but basically it's still yours and it's still your AI. So it depends on what do you want them to do. The authenticity of that is still in a debate, yeah, because that's the debate in the academic world, yeah, whether that lesson plan is from you or from Copilot. And so I mean, if it's effective, why not? We take ideas from Copilot and so on. The other debate about the ethic of using AI is like, I don't know, have you heard of people creating an article from AI? I believe that it started to emerge, and then a lot of people say that it will kill journalism and then so on. Okay, so that authenticity part, I think it's still left to debate. Yeah, whether we should be authentic or not in preparing a lesson, whether we should do this and do that in preparing whether it's ethical to use a lesson plan prepared by AI for our lessons. Well, I think it remains a question, and I think it will open a door to another deeper and more focused discussion on that case. So yeah, for that question, that's the answer that I can provide for now. Yeah, but we are welcome. If there is a forum to talk more about that, yeah, I'm welcome. I'll be happy to join.
Okay. Do you still have time for one more question, maybe, for a participant? Is there any more question that you want to ask to Mr. Didi? Maybe?
Yeah, I think there is a...
No one. Oh, there is one.
There are two more questions from the file, I think,
Yeah,
from Zoom.
but it's only choosing, right? Choosing one
Yeah.
from the Zoom, one from the YouTube. Yeah, I don't think we can cover all the questions. So, yeah, so I think for now, I think Mr. Didi can close the session.
All right. Thank you very much, everyone, for your participation today. And I hope everything that we talked about today can be useful again for your teaching. And in general, for your own personal development. I've been using AI even before ChatGPT was a thing, actually. I mean, I tried different things, but the advancement of AI these days has me to, okay, I think it's a really in a really really fast pace. So as a teacher, you either use it or you either be left behind by it. So therefore, I think as a good teacher with experience in technology, I believe that everybody should utilize AI instead of, you don't always have to use AI in your every lesson, in your every classroom, but at least you know what to do, because there's a possibility that your student might be using AI too in tricking you. So if you don't know that, that's a big minus in these days. And there is a question actually that I would like to answer. Yeah, will AI replace teacher one day? Honest answer, I don't know. Looking at the advancements of AI, I think looking at the advancement of AI, but I think, well, asking if AI will replace teachers or not is like asking if AI will replace human or not. So, will AI replace human in many ways? Because the main thing about being a teacher is being human first, right? I mean, yeah, the other things would follow. So I think that could be the answer for me. Yeah. However, yeah, AI is a tool. So therefore, yeah, use this tool to your own need and maximize the use of it so that you can be a better teacher, a better classroom, and of course, better learning experience for our students. I think that's all from me. Thank you very much for joining in. See you in other occasions. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Didi. So what an eye-opener. We have a create formula. It is to maximize our usage in the using the AI assistant. Anyway,